2020 has been a radical year to say the least, and I think that is putting it mildly. I mean, never before have we kind of seen this kind of a pause button or a stop button on the wheels of change in the whole world. I mean, I think pre-pandemic, the whole world was moving at this absolute rocket speed, in terms of change of trends, in terms of change of fads, in terms of how quickly we were consuming imagery, how red carpet was affecting. Micro trends every day. I mean, you'd see like a new Instagram post from a celebrity, and that'll kind of set off a whole tsunami of fashion trends. And what the pandemic did is suddenly kind of grind it all to a massive halt, where there were no more red carpets, there were no parties or award functions or public appearances or weddings, and everything just kind of went on standstill mode. And I think what this has done really, I mean, I can speak on my behalf, is it's really given people a chance to pause, to stop that automated, gears that people were on, to pause and reflect on who we are, where we have been going, who we want to be, and how does that affect our, choices as consumers, as creators, and how does it kind of affect everything that you kind of choose to consciously or subconsciously do. So as a designer, I think what it really made me was, it made me quieter about the lockdown was that I became a father last year. I mean, I could spend a lot of time with her, 24 hours a day at home, relaxed. We could hear bird song outside my window. We could, I mean, the snarling traffic of Bombay came to a halt. So it was a very kind of a meditative, kind of a quiet time. Just so filled with overconsumption and kind of discarding of clothes. And as shameful as it may be, fashion is one of the most polluting industries in the world, in that sense. And almost all clothes end up in a landfill, which is really sad. So this pandemic has given me a chance to kind of reinforce that idea for myself and really focus on beautiful collectible classics, stuff that you want to wear now and maybe wear in 5 years. I think you really realize how little you need, And I mean, I don't want to kind of shoot myself or the industry in the foot. We need to be more happy with buying fewer things, buying nicer things, buying things that are ethically made. I mean, I've always wondered, like, I mean, if a t-shirt costs less than a burger or a packet of chips, there's something really wrong in the system, because I mean, you're looking at the number of processes involved that kind of go into it, the longevity of what it should be. And clothes, I think, are something that, like, I mean, I live out of a uniform and I have clothes that I wear for work, which are kind of 12 sets of the same every day, so I don't have to think about it. But I enjoy kind of cherishing things. I mean, when I look at old saris in my mother's wardrobe, or I look at stuff that people have got over generations or over the years, there is a sense of attached love and memories for those, which no amount of disposable high street wear will ever replicate. But I hope people won't go back to that kind of mindless, senseless consumption where,
Of course,
It's
yeah.
just the flavor of the minute or the flavor of the second kind of a thing, but really kind of focus on their choices.
Yeah.
But I hope we will kind of go back to with a renewed sense of gratitude, a renewed sense of appreciation of what we have, and trying to kind of correct wrongs that have been for the last many years and a couple of decades for sure, as opposed to trying to kind of go back down that same path again. I think sustainability has been a clarion call which had to be answered a while ago. So it's not like, I mean, it's already late in terms of what have we done to the planet per se. But there's a lot of greenwashing in the name of sustainability in the minds of the industry as well as the consumer. So just because you buy a shapeless gray linen frock, doesn't mean it's sustainable. You have to be tough with yourself in terms of what is sustainable for you. I think comfort will definitely be in. I think there's also something about beautiful, soothing, happy colors, which I personally have believed in. Like a lovely butter yellow or a beautiful peach or a gorgeous mint green or, a dressy Indian mango or a nice runny pink. I mean, there's so many beautiful colors, in that sense, which really you feel happy wearing these clothes. I think so that will be a trend for sure. And when it comes to Indian wear or Indian festive dressing, I think people want clothes which feel lighter, for years. I mean, those days are gone when brides would brag about, like their lehenga weighing 30 kilos and how it left bruises on you. Today's brides want to dance. I mean, they want sneakers. They want, stuff that they can twirl in for Instagram. I mean, they're not interested in wearing stuff which is going to, weigh as much as the ghodi, the groom came on, I mean.